Marvy here, and today I'm going to be telling you a little bit about the Irish and the wearing of the green. That's why I am dressed in all of this green. So we're going to talk a little bit more about it, but did you just see something go across? I think I saw something go across. What was that? It looked kind of like my beard and my hat, but you see, the St. Patrick's Day is when leprechauns come out, and its story goes that if you find their pot of gold, you might be rich, or they might give you three wishes. I've never caught one, so I don't know. I'm looking around, but I don't know if I... Well, I have my leprechaun decoration, and I'm wearing the green. Green is for the letter G, but I thought I saw something go across that looked like a leprechaun. Keep your eyes open. Maybe we'll see one. I know our story's going to be about it. So we're going to look at the letter G again today. G goes like this. This is an uppercase G and a lowercase G, and it's for the colors green, like my hat, and gold, like my bag, or like the leprechaun's gold. And let me show you a picture. Ireland is a place that is far away from us. We live around here on the map, and across the ocean over here is where Ireland is, and that's where the leprechauns come from. So in honor of St. Patrick's Day and the leprechauns, I'm wearing the green, and that's why I had my beard and my hat on today. And today we're going to have a story about a leprechaun and his gold and the letter G. So let's take a look at some things that I have that begin with the letter G. I have books about the garden. This is called Fluffy Grows a Garden. And this one's called Oh, John the Rabbit. And it's about that rabbit trying to sneak some things out of the garden. And back here I have a gorilla for the letter G. And I have another book about the garden, and it's called There Wasn't a Lady Who Swallowed a Frog. Oh my goodness. And I have another book that's called The Pot of Gold, and it's green. Well, this is the letter G for gold and green, and I'm just gonna take a quick look and see if we can look at this. Sometimes leprechauns are supposed to look a little bit like elves. Now you know what the elf on the shelf looks like, but there he is trying to make sure no one steals his gold. This man wants his gold, and he's trying to trick him so that he doesn't catch him or get his gold. There he is looking for it. He's trying to catch the little elf or leprechaun. Leprechaun is what I'm going to call him. He looks like an elf though. And he's looking underneath the trees and he's trying to find his pot of gold. Well, you see, those leprechauns are tricky and they surely don't want to tell you where their pot of gold is, because then they won't have their treasures anymore. So maybe we'll find out what happens in the story that we have today about the leprechaun and the pot of gold. I also have another story, and it's called The Three Billy Goats Gruff. You may know that story. I'm going to show you a big picture of it. And here we have the mean and the nasty troll who didn't like it when the three goats went across. He wanted to eat them. There was just too much noise, and he kept hearing trip, trap, trip, trap on top of his bridge. So the first billy goat said, oh, don't eat me, eat my brother. He's bigger, better. And the second one said, oh, don't eat me, eat my brother. And the last billy goat, small, medium, and large, he knocked the troll over, fell in the water, and didn't have to deal with the troll anymore. So maybe you would like to read that book too, The Three Billy Goats Gruff. Let's take a look at some more of my G things that I have. This is a globe, and I showed you a flat version of what our Earth looks like. But when the astronauts go into space, they see a round blue one with some brown, and the brown is usually the land, and lots of blue. That's the water, because we have a lot of water on our planet. This is a gorilla. He's getting ready, it looks like, to pound his chest, and we see a gorilla over here. I have Grover, who's on Sesame Street, and he helps us with our letters and our numbers, and his name begins with G. Something I love to eat is this, grapes. And there's a girl here, and behind her is the garden. So, oh, wait, and here's a garden over here. And it looks like there are lots of fairies in that garden. Well, my goodness, I think I need to find out more about that. I have a garbage collector, and our story's gonna help us find out more about the fairies. And I have a goat, both begin with the letter G, and a gate. There is a gate that opens for the fairies' garden. This is the gate. Well, it looks like a door there. Here you can see the gate, and there are G's all over them. Where are the G's? Are there any G's in this row? No. Any G's in this row? No. Any G's in this row? No. Thumbs down. I see G, 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 all on the gate. And are there any G's in this one? No, don't be fooled by this. It looks a little bit like the lowercase g, but that's a Q. So those are some G's on the gate. Now, let's see how we write the letter G. I'm going to go like this. I'll come around, stop, draw a line across, and stop. I don't want to do this because it looks almost like I'm going to make a six. So I'll come around, stop, put the line across, lowercase g. Circle goes around and the hook comes down. Circle goes around and the hook goes down. Can you try that with me? Circle goes around and the hook goes down. 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 One more time for the letter G. I have this. This is an uppercase G. Let's have our goat go on the path. It goes around like this, stop, and we make the line across. You can make the line go across this way, or you can go that way. Either way is fine, just so it has a little point and not a curve like we see there. So let's look at our stories that I have that are about leprechauns and gold, the letter G. Here we go. This one is the leprechaun in the basement, and he's looking at his gold. And the leprechauns are little people, so that's why they're hard and they're quick. I've never seen one, but I know that I found things messed up and I found things all over the place. And people tell me that that's because of the leprechauns. I don't know if it's true. And this one is the luckiest leprechaun. And that's the one I'm going to read to you today. And I have the Itsy Bitsy Leprechaun. And this is so quick. I'm going to read it with you because it's a song. It's to the tune of Itsy Bitsy Spider. So it goes like this. The Itsy Bitsy Leprechaun was hiding pots of gold. Down came a rainbow, colorful and bold. That's why I have the rainbow. Out came his friends and they all began to look. He's doing a little dance. For the perfect four-leaf clover hidden in this nook. It's the Itsy Bitsy Leprechaun, loved to search and find. With his good luck, he was magical and kind. They found the plant and the leprechaun did say, may the sun shine up upon you, happy St. Patrick's Day. Oh, there's his pot of gold and he's not worried about anybody taking it. He's having a good time. Oh, that looks lovely. Oh. And something that you can do before we start reading our story, if you wanted to have some green and gold, you could make some snazzy jewelry. I got some green beads and some gold beads, and I put them on a pipe cleaner, and now I made a bracelet. But I have a pattern. Let's see if we can figure out what the pattern is supposed to be, but I messed up on purpose. I've got gold and green and gold and green and gold and green and gold and green. And what should be next? There's something wrong. It should be gold, then green, then gold, then green, if I want to continue the pattern. If you want to make one, you can try and make a pattern too. Maybe you don't want to make the same one as me, but you can try to make a pattern too. So I messed up on purpose to see if you could find it. See? Gold, green, gold, green. In here, I forgot to put the gold. And then I can wrap it around my wrist and have a bracelet. Well, I'm going to read the luckiest leprechaun, and I'm going to sound a little bit like the people from Ireland sound. It's a tail-wagging tale of friendship. It's by Justine Corman and illustrated by Denise Brunkus. And here we go. And there's the fairies in the garden. The fairies, I wonder if they're guarding the gold for the leprechaun. Mackenzie O'Shamrock at your service, but you can call me Mac. I'm a leprechaun, and I don't care if you believe in me or not. Get too close and I'll show you who's real with me hammer. I may be small, but we leprechauns are not to be trifled with. There, now, that's settled. Pull up a toadstool or a chair if you're too big, and I'll tell you my story. I was born beneath a fairy hill, back when time was new. Ever since I've been making shoes for all the fairy folk, and guarding all me gold from greedy people. Treasure hunters have to get up pretty early in the morning to get the best of Mackenzie O'Shamrock. Since leprechauns work at night and sleep during the day, I'm up much earlier than most. No, they haven't made the human yet who could outsmart me.
See any yet?
Can you find him? He's hiding under the toadstool. Then people found a new way to boil my potatoes. They stopped believing in leprechauns. They believed in all sorts of nonsense, but the little man making the shoes beneath their very own hedge couldn't possibly exist.
It got so all like children and almost like Professor Chester believed in me. I didn't need people anyway. I had a nice home under a tree in a quiet park. As long as I had me gold and me work, this leprechaun was content. Every night I cobbled for the fairies. Since all the little things do is dance and lose their shoes, business was steady. Every morning I'd pack away me tools and curl up in me cozy bed. And that's just what I was doing one fine morning when I heard a horrible scratching overhead. Dirt poured down on me favorite armchair as a pair of giant paws burst through the ceiling. My theme book collection clattered to the floor. I grabbed my hammer and I ran outside to see who was wrecking my home. I expected a goblin or some other horrible monster. Oh my goodness, can you figure out what it is? There's your clue at the top. I found a shaggy red-haired dog burying a stinky soup bone. Hello, she barked. Who are you? I'm Mackenzie O'Shamrock, I shouted, and you've got some nerve destroying my home. You'll not be stealing my gold, you mangy malter, so just take your bone and go. I'm sorry. I didn't realize that anyone was living here, the dog said. Is that your gold? It's very pretty. Go, shoo, get lost, I shouted. The dog didn't budge. Shaking her head, she said, I feel terrible. I've got to make this up to you. I'll fix your house. I'll be your guard dog. I don't need a guard, I said. But you must need a friend. Everyone needs friends, the dog said. My name is Lucky. What's yours? That made me even madder. Mackenzie O'Shamrock, I yelled. Oh, that's right. You did tell me, Lucky replied. But that's so much to remember. May I just call you Mac? I hope we'll be friends. Everything's more fun when you do it together, don't you think? Just the other day, I... Lucky would have gone on like that for hours, but I told her to go away and stay away. Apparently, stay was the only command the dumb dog knew. From then on, wherever I went, there was Lucky. She was slobbering over me when I woke up at dusk. She was on me heels while I gathered cobwebs for the fairy thread. Oh, boy. I don't think he wants her, but Lucky wants to be there. Oh, and there's the fairies. Lucky even tailed me when I made my deliveries to the fairy. And she always had a tearful word or 100. It drove me nuts. That dog was even happy when it rained. Rain is where rainbows come from. Lucky said, I love rainbows. Don't you? I could chase them all day. Why don't you go chase them so I can get some quiet around here, I growled. After a while, Lucky learned not to talk so much, especially when I first woke up in the morning. I won't say we became friends, but she got to be slightly less annoying. Speaking of annoying, remember that human I mentioned a while back? The oddball who believed in leprechauns? That's right, Professor Chester. Well, he started snooping around my park. Here he is. He's got his net. And he's got his magnifying glass. Let's see if he finds him. He's after my gold, I cried. Maybe he just wants to be friends, Lucky suggested. I snorted. Humans want only one thing from a leprechaun, gold. But he won't get the best of Mackenzie O'Shamrock. Professor Chester was getting dangerously close. He even found a fairy shoe. Don't worry, Max, said Lucky. You've got your guard dog. Remember, I won't let anything happen to your gold. I took no comfort in the mutt's ravings.
I watched Professor Chester poring over his books of leprechaun lore.
If only I could prove their existence, he muttered.
I shuddered. Maybe he'll just go away, Lucky said. I thought about packing up, but I liked my cozy life under the tree. Besides, business was good, and it's not so easy to find a park filled with fairies. Then, one day, while I was sleeping, the professor found my tree. He was about to capture me and would have gotten me gold for sure when... Lucky came charging out of the woods. The professor cried, "Help! Monster! Help!" He dropped his map and ran off screaming. I thought I was having a nightmare. I rolled over with a groan and fell right back to sleep. Professor Chester just kept running until he wore out the soles of his shoes. Turned out the professor was scared of dogs. Okay, so there's Max still and sleeping. That evening, I woke up feeling something was wrong. For one thing, the dumb dog wasn't licking my face. Suddenly, with a jerk, I remembered the nightmare. I checked for me gold in all me secret hiding places. It was gone, and so was Lucky. I called Lucky's name until my voice was hoarse, but there was no answer. I felt as if I had lost my shadow and my friend. Then it hit me. My worst fear had come true. The dog wasn't as silly as she seemed. Lucky duped me into trusting her. That means tricked. As soon as I'd let her down my guard, she'd run off with me gold. Hi, Mackenzie O'Shamrock, the smartest leprechaun of them all, had finally been tricked out of my treasure. I searched the park for hours, but there was no sign of me got my gold or of Lucky. I found myself... I told myself that the dog had skipped off with my treasure, but part of me didn't believe it. One minute, I was furious, and the next, I was worried. What if the stupid pooch had chased a rainbow into traffic or gotten herself taken to the pound? I couldn't even keep my mind on my missing gold.
Ah, so he's worried about his friend, Lucky.
By dawn, I was the saddest leprechaun in the world. After centuries of being suspicious, I'd finally opened my heart and pow! The first friend I'd made had stolen my gold. The sun came up and I wiped away a tear. Then a voice behind me said,
"Why are you crying?"
I turned and saw Lucky and my gold. "Where were you?" I yelled. I was worried sick. Lucky licked my face.
"You do care. I knew we'd be friends."
I wiped the dog's slobber from my face and grumbled, "I was worried about my gold." But Lucky explained that she had seen Professor Chester nosing around near my tree. And after she'd chased him away, she'd hidden my treasure in the tool shed just to make sure it was safe. Then, worn out from all the excitement, she'd fallen asleep.
"Did you really spend all night looking for me?" Lucky asked.
"And the gold," I added hastily. But the damage was done. The dog knew I cared, and she wouldn't stop wagging her tail over it. So, there's my story. Leprechaun gets gold, leprechauns get dog, leprechaun loses gold. Leprechaun admits that a loyal friend is worth more than the gold, as long as the friend doesn't slobber too much. Now if that isn't a tale worth telling upon a toadstool, I'm sure I don't know what is.
And that's the story. So, he had his gold saved after all. Lucky was a good friend and a good watchdog. And, you know, there might be something else that our friend Mackenzie O'Shamrock likes. Maybe some gumballs. So let's see if we can find some gumballs for him. I'm going to use the magnifying glass and see. Oh, wait a minute. I see numbers. These are numbers, but the letter G is not a number. Let's take off of the gumballs and see what the letters are underneath. Let's see. Is this a G? If it is, thumbs up. If it isn't, thumbs down. You can see the G behind me too. Let's try another one for lucky. Is that a G? No, it's a J. Thumbs down. Let's look at this one. Is that a G? Why, yes, it is. Thumbs up. That's an uppercase G. Another gumball. Let's take a look over here. Is that a G? Yes, thumbs up. Is that a G? Thumbs down. That is a number 9. Do I have any more? Yes, I do. Is that a G? Why, yes, it is. That's an uppercase G. Is that a G? No, that's the letter B. Thumbs down. I'm gonna take off the rest of the gumballs and see. Is that a G? Yes, it is. Is that a G? No, that is an uppercase A. Is that a G? No, thumbs down. That is the letter D. Well, I think that's enough gumballs to give to Mackenzie O'Shamrock. And we know that Lucky can't eat gumballs because dogs don't eat them. But I do have some gold. Ooh, G is for gold. And I have pots of gold. And let's see if we can pick out the one that goes with the number I hold up. Let me start with this one. Well, 0 means nothing, so I won't put anything in that pot of gold. Let's see if I can pick another one. This would be the number 1. Which one has 1? Oh my goodness. Let me see. This is 1. 1. And that's 1 piece of gold. Wow. Well, this just came down. So let's see if we can count this and find the number that goes with this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. It's the number 8. Let me see if I can find the number 8. This is 8, and there's 8 pieces for this pot of gold. Next, I'm gonna try this one. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I have the number 6 here. 6 pieces of gold for Mackenzie O'Shamrock. And one more. I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. You can hold up that many fingers too. And that's the number 4 pieces for Mackenzie O'Shamrock. Well, I know what happened. Let's see if I see the leprechaun. Oh my goodness. Maybe that's what I saw going across the screen. Oh my. I'm going to use my magnifying glass. Can you see the pot of gold? I'm looking. I see leprechauns. I see pictures of leprechauns. I found the pot of gold. Here it is. And there you go. So it's a pretend pot of gold. Ah, oh, he wouldn't give me his real gold, but there's a lucky four-leaf clover on it. So hopefully I'll have a lucky day. And with that, remember, we talked about the letter G today for green and gold. So until next time, it's Miss Marvy. Happy St. Patrick's Day!